on, but also for a reason. Why? What happens here with my body that makes me then fall forward? What's happening with my body? My shoulders, specifically. My shoulders are going where? Out in front, right? So my shoulders are falling out in front of my knees, right? How about over here? When my shoulders fall back, what happens? Right? I'm having to catch my balance. So my shoulders are falling either in front of or behind my knees, right? That's just an easy little self-check, kind of a self-checkpoint for you guys. When you're in a match and you're in your position, is that if your shoulders fall either forward or behind your knees, there's probably a good chance that you're out of position, right? And the reason I bring that up is as we hand fight, some of you guys, you're pounding and it's awesome. You've got the right idea as far as intensity goes, but there's a lot of this kind of stalking forward. I see your shoulders up in front of your knees, right? And maybe your partner's not quite feeling that and taking that snap like Joey did, right? I really want to encourage you guys to keep your shoulders, keep your knees underneath your shoulders when you're in the fight, all right? And keeping that pressure on. So the other thing I noticed when we were out hand fighting was, I said, all right, hey, let's keep going. A lot of guys just walk out of their stance, they put their hands on, right? Stance, right? And, hey, listen, you guys are all experienced wrestlers. I see the bios in the folder that Cliff made, right? But I'll tell you what, the higher level you expect to compete at, the better your fundamentals skills need to be. The first thing you learn in wrestling is your stance, right? The better your stance needs to be, the higher level you expect to compete at. With the World Championships coming up next week, take note of not just the moves that are happening, but what kind of position you're in while they're out there wrestling, right? They're in terrific position. And you watch this kind of thing. Our three checkpoints are to keep our toes and knees and shoulders in line. Anytime my shoulders get out in front, it's where I get off balance, right? So I want to make sure that you guys are down into your stance. When you go to drill, we'll go out to hand fight again a little bit. But I want you to just focus on this thing right now, is how to just close the gap, all right? You're building discipline here. You're building your habits, which you need if you're going to expect to wrestle successfully in college. Right, closing this distance down, right, whether you're making contact with your backhand, right, or just bringing your entire body with you and having your forehead make that first contact. As I stalk into Joey, right, you notice what's happening here, turn sideways, right, I'm not allowing this to come forward, right, I'm never out here where he can just fire off to my legs. It's always moving my entire body as one piece as I'm stalking forward into him, all right? So I want you to close that gap, and then be real just conscious about keeping your knees underneath your shoulders as you bring some forward pressure into your partner, all right? So closing that gap on him. Now we've got our hands on, all right? I'm gonna stalk forward, keeping this lead knee underneath my shoulder as I'm pressuring into Joey, right? Stalking him back a little bit, right? And then of course what happens? You put some pressure on the guy, and at some point, as we're closing that gap, putting pressure on, right, we feel that right there. See what happened with his back foot? Right, that's my cue, and that's what we're looking for, is to feel that pressure, right? We'll build on that in just a minute, but I wanna bring you out, right? Another little detail, when you're getting your hands on the guys, let's make sure we're not just hands up, definitely not lead arm, lead leg, but work your hands from down low, up to high, and inside to out, right? As we're stalking, and I'm inside, you can see where Joey's right hand just came up to my shoulder. My left hand then works from low, it's gonna work up high, and inside. So low to high, inside to out, right? Inside to out, then we pressure, stalking, keeping my knee underneath the shoulder, and that's what I'm looking for, is him to brace that foot, right? Can we do that? Just check your height. Right, good position, keep your knee underneath your shoulder as you close the gap and then bring forward pressure, make him brace his foot. Or else what happens? He either goes out of bounds, if we're wrestling freestyle or whatever, maybe folk style season, he's gonna get called, all right? So put that pressure on and make him brace on his back foot. All right, on the back, 1, 2, 3.